July 4th, 1776.
He has called together legislative bodies at places unusual, uncomfortable, and distant from the depository of their public records, for the sole purpose of fatiguing them into compliance with his measures. He has dissolved representative houses repeatedly for opposing with manly firmness his invasions on the rights of the people. He has refused for a long time after such disillusions to cause others to be elected, after such disillusions whereby the legislative powers incapable of annihilation have returned to the people at large for their exercise, the states remaining in the meantime exposed to all the dangers of invasions from without and convulsions from within. He has endeavored to prevent the population of these states for that purpose obstructing the laws for the naturalization of foreigners, refusing to pass others to encourage their migrations hither, and raising the conditions of new appropriations of lands. He has obstructed the administration of justice by refusing his assent to laws for establishing judiciary powers. He has made judges dependent on his will alone for the tenure of their offices and the amount and payment of their salaries. He has kept among us in times of peace standing armies without the consent of our legislatures.
He has affected to render the military independent of the law and superior to the civil power.
He has combined with others to subject us to jurisdiction foreign to our Constitution and unacknowledged by our laws, giving his assent to their acts of pretended legislation, for quartering large bodies of armed troops among us, for cutting off our trade with all parts of the world, for imposing taxes on us without our consent, for depriving of us many cases of the benefits of trial by jury, for taking away our charters, abolishing our most valuable laws, and altering fundamentally the forms of our government, for suspending our own legislatures and declaring themselves invested with power to legislate for us in all cases whatsoever. He has abdicated government here by declaring us out of his protection and waging war against us. He has plundered our seas, ravaged our coasts, burned our towns, and destroyed the lives of our people. We have petitioned for redress in most humble terms. Our repeated petitions have been answered only by repeated injury. A prince whose character is thus marked by every act which may define a tyrant is unfit to be the ruler of a free people. We, therefore, the representatives of the United States of America, in General Congress assembled, appealing to the most supreme judge of the world for the rectitude of our intentions, do, in the name and by the authority of the good people of these colonies, solemnly publish and declare that these United Colonies are, and are right ought to be, free and independent states.
And for the support of this declaration, with a firm reliance on the protection of the divine providence, we
I'm ready for this challenge, and I was built for this.
I think we all have a purpose in life, and mine's going to take on a task that most of us back away from, that impossible, some people say is impossible, I see possibilities, I don't see anything as being impossible.
Mentalities, there are different mentalities, but just like here's different ways to teach people how to read, there's different ways to communicate people, it's different ways to communicate people and